Okay, so in this video, I'm gonna cover let function in Excel. Let function is one of the new functions introduced in Office 365 recently, and it's a great function if you're an advanced Excel user. Usually when I work in Excel, there is always something in Google Sheets that I wish Excel had. And this is where it's the opposite. This is something that's available in Excel that I wish Google Sheets had. So what let function allows you to do is to create variables inside of your functions. I'm gonna do a few examples. We'll start with a very basic example, and then I'll go to cases when it will actually make sense to use the function. But let's start with the basics. So if I do equals let, so the first thing in this is the variable name. So you basically just give it a variable name, no spaces, no quotations or anything, just a name. And it can be anything. It could be like word, that's a variable name, or you could just call it X, stay with something classic, right? That would be the name of the variable. Now I'm gonna do comma, and then I'm gonna do the value for that variable, X. So for example, if we do 5, that means we're making that X equal to 5. So after the next comma, we do the calculation, and this calculation may include that value. So for example, I can take that X and I can add 9 to it. So at this point, what should happen? This X should be 5. 5 plus 9 should give us 14. And there it is, that's our 14. So where would you use it and why would it make sense to use this? So the way you would know that you need let function is when you see the same calculation happening in your formula multiple times. So here we have a spreadsheet. So let's say I'm trying to apply some sort of commission to the salespeople based on their sales and profit margin. So in cases when the profit margin is going to be above a certain percentage point, I would like to give them a certain percentage commission compared to other cases when profit margin is less. So let's just start with the profit margin. So we can get the profit margin by taking sales minus the cost like this, and then we can divide it by the sales amount. So that should give us our profit margin. Let me actually zoom in here more. We could also get it in a different way, which would be the same formula. We could just take 1 minus, and we can take the cost and divide it by the sales price, which should give us the same thing. And this way we wouldn't have to use that multiple times, right? Doesn't matter. So both of these are profit margins. I'm going to use the second variation for this. So if I drag this formula down, we'll see these are the percentages. So this is 42%, this is 57%, we got 6%, and so on. So what I want to do now, I want to do some sort of if statement if this profit margin here is above 50%, then let's say I'm gonna do 20% commission from sales. If it's above 40%, I'm gonna do 15% commission from sales. And in all the other cases, I'm gonna do, let's say, 10%. Hopefully I'll remember what this was, but it really doesn't matter. So what I'm gonna do here, I'm gonna go in here and put this calculation inside of ifs statement. So ifs function, let's spell that correctly. So I'm gonna say if this calculation that I just did, and I'm gonna have to put that in parentheses to group it all together. So if that, I'm gonna say, is greater than 50% or 0.5, then I would like to take the sales amount here and multiply it by 0.2, which is that 20%, comma. Now the next logical statement is gonna be if it's above 40%. Now to do that, I will have to basically repeat this whole thing here. So I'm gonna copy that and paste it here. So again, if this profit margin this time is greater than 40%, comma, then I'm gonna take this and multiply it by 0.15. So that's my 15%, comma. And in all the other cases, so to do that, I'll just do true. I want to just apply 10% commission. So I'm going to take this and multiply it by 0.1. Close parentheses and hit enter. And this should now give me that. Okay. So this is the formula. I did not use let or anything. So what I'm doing here, I'm just checking if this profit margin is greater than this, then do this. If this profit margin is greater than this other number, do this other number. And you could have multiple more times of this calculation repeating. But the main thing here that I'm trying to show you is that in this formula, we have the same calculation repeating twice. We have this profit margin calculation once here, and then we have another time that same calculation happening here. So if you have something like this, let function can improve this formula quite a bit. So how do we use it? We go back in front of this ifs statement and we start with our let function. And in our let function, I'm just going to push this with spaces to the right so it doesn't get on the way. I'm going to declare a variable name. I'm just going to call it margin. So comma, and the way I'm going to take this margin to get its value, instead of just typing like it's 4 or 5 or 6, I'm actually going to replace it with this calculation right here that calculates our profit margin. So I'm just going to copy and paste it over here. I could put it in parentheses if I wanted to, but it's separated by commas in our formula, so it doesn't matter. So now this calculation will be our profit margin, which will be stored in this variable called margin, which means now I can just do after the comma, my calculation, which will be the same ifs statement. Only now I can just refer to that profit margin with this variable margin. So I'll just copy this, go back and select this first thing here and paste it. So that's going to be margin. And then I'm going to go take the first instance of that same calculation and the second one, and both of them I'm going to replace with the variable called margin. And the rest is going to remain the same. So because this parentheses is closing this ifs function, I need another one to close my let function like this. And if I hit enter, I should be getting the same results doing this. But what's good about this is that we just have the calculation happening once. So now we have a couple of things happening here. The first thing, Excel doesn't have to redo the calculation all over again. It's just going to do it once, store it in a variable, and every time it's going to know what the answer is and use the answer in a variable instead of repeating the calculation. So we're getting performance boost by doing this. And the second reason, it's easier to update. So if we need to update this margin calculation to be something different, all we have to do is do it in one spot. Now, another thing in this formula that you could add to this, it's not going to give us so much of a performance boost, but what it will let us do, it will let us simplify updates to this formula. In this formula, I can see that I'm using this E2, see, once, twice, 3, and 4 times. So I'm using that same reference E2 in multiple places. So if we had to change that to a different cell instead of E2, we need to go through this formula in 4 different places and update E2 to whatever the new cell is. So instead, what I can do, I can just go in front of this let function before I even get to this part where I declare this variable margin. I can go in front of this and just create another variable and call this one amount, or sales amount, or whatever you want to call this, comma. And what that amount is going to be is the value of our sales. So I'm going to do E2, comma. And then now, from this point on, starting from here in my formula, I'm going to refer to that E2 using this amount variable. So I'm going to copy that amount variable, go here. Instead of this E2, I'm going to paste it here. Instead of this E2, and for all of them, I'm going to do this. And now I should be able to get the same results, but we only refer to E2 cell once. So if we need to update this to a different cell, we can do it by changing just one thing in our formula without having to find all of these E2 instances. Now, the key thing to remember when you declare variables here, they're available from the point that you declare it. So it's important to declare this E2 and this amount in this first part of this function, because the second variable that I declare, margin, is going to use that amount in this calculation. So to be able to use this amount, it needs to be declared previously in the formula. By previously, we mean to the left over here. So the order here makes a difference. So that's one example of using let to improve our formulas. So as you can see, we got our results. So again, the key thing here, if you see a repeating pattern in your formula, the same calculation that repeats multiple times, you can take that and improve that using let function. Now, let me show you another example with a VLOOKUP. Looking at this data, let's say we have this tiny table on the left and this other tiny table on the right, and we're trying to pull prices from this right table to this left table. So I'm just gonna go ahead and copy this, paste it here, and then I'm gonna do a VLOOKUP. And again, this tutorial is not gonna be covering VLOOKUP. I have videos covering those functions. I'm gonna do VLOOKUP and take this value on the left as a lookup value, comma, and then go and select this table on the right as our lookup table. I'm gonna do F4 to make that absolute reference to stay in place, comma, and then the column number, if I wanted to get prices, would be 1, 2, 3, 4, comma, and this is gonna be exact match, which is false or zero option. So if I do that, hit enter, see I get the appropriate price for this particular stock number. So as you can see, for that, it's 5814. Now I'm gonna take this and drag it down to show you what are some issues we may have with this particular formula. So right now, if you look here, we got a zero for this 67622 6160. And if I check and see where that particular item is, it's the second item in this table. And as you can see, the price is blank. And similar to that, if I look at this 524, which is right here, the price is also blank. So in Excel, the way the VLOOKUP implementation works, if whatever you return is blank, it basically just gives you a zero. And if it doesn't find a match, like in this case, see this one that ends with 874, which is just not available. So there's no matching stock number. In that case, we get an NA. Now, in this case, when we get a zero, we do have a matching stock number, but because the value for price is blank, it returns a zero. So now I want to deal with this. So I want to make sure that when it's zero, we change it to a blank. When it's an NA, we want to change it to something else, possibly even blank too, or maybe we'll just say not available. So let's start with dealing with zeros. So what I would have to do, I'm gonna have to go back here and do an if statement. I'm gonna say if this VLOOKUP return equals to zero, then comma, I'm gonna do a blank text, comma. Otherwise, what I want to be returned is the result of that VLOOKUP. So basically I would have to just copy the same function all over again, go back after this and paste it, and close parentheses for if function and hit enter. And now what's going to happen if I drag this down, you'll see that these are giving me blank, because what happens is that we check if the result is zero, we replace that zero with a blank space. Now at this point, I could take this formula and take care of that NA using some sort of if error. So I can do if error, and if the result of that is an error, then I'm gonna go all the way to the end, do a comma, and then replace it with unknown. I'm gonna hit enter, and if I drag this formula down, you'll see that we're gonna get blanks for this and unknown for this one. So again, if you look at this formula, what we have is the same calculation repeating more than once. So we have VLOOKUP here that does that lookup, and we have another VLOOKUP here that does that same thing all over again. So again, the problem with this is that it's gonna do this VLOOKUP once to search and find that value, and then it's gonna compare if that's a zero. But if it's not zero, it's gonna do the VLOOKUP all over again the second time to go get the value. So we have a very large performance hit. So how do we make this better? We use let function. So I go to the left here and do let, and basically whatever it is that we're searching for. So I'm gonna say let price equal to, well, not equal to, comma. And after the comma, I'm gonna do that VLOOKUP function. So I'm gonna copy this and paste right after that. So we're saying the price should be the result of this VLOOKUP function, comma. So at this point, what I can do, starting after that comma, I just use the rest of the function, and I just need to replace all the VLOOKUPs with this variable that I called price. So I'm gonna copy that, go back to this, and select this first VLOOKUP, paste price instead, and then select the second VLOOKUP as well, and paste. And now we should be able to work with this. So basically now we have much cleaner formula. We're checking if the price is zero, then leave it blank, otherwise use the price. And the rest we're gonna leave as is. Now I do need another parenthesis closing for my let function in the end of this. So I'm gonna add that, hit enter. And now if I drag this formula down, I should be getting exactly the same results. So once again, we had repeating calculation in the same formula. So we replaced it with let function with a variable, so it doesn't have to repeat that calculation. All right, so that hopefully gives you some ideas how you use let function and where it could be beneficial. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video.